Hey, what's up? Welcome to another episode of Possum. I'm Bandit, and today I've got...
Kai!
And today we're actually doing a bit of a recap with Kai because we haven't really gotten a chance to hang out with her on the show for a while. And, you know, she's been busy doing a lot of stuff, doing a lot of dance competitions. So, you know, we're going to get a little bit of an interview with her. It's really good to finally get the chance to talk to you and hang out with you. I mean, I see you at a few of the events on occasion, but you're always all over the place or you're just leaving when I'm getting there.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm really glad to be able to hang out with you. So, I've noticed that you were at a few conventions recently. I didn't get to go to some of them, but you were in a lot of the dance competitions. Mm-hmm. Most recently, I saw you at the Further Confusion competition, you know, this year. And your performance was amazing as always. Do you usually do your practicing, like, in front of a mirror, at a suit, or in suit? I think we talked about this before.
Yeah, I actually practice in the garage. I wish I had a mirror, because that would be so useful, but I practice out of suit most of the time, but I've been trying to get more, like, in suit practicing than that, because, honestly, practicing out of suit and in suit is totally two different things, in a way. I mean, you have, like, I mean, the movements... suits, you have to be more exaggerated in the movements, and then in, you know, without the suit, it's not like that. It's a little, actually, it's more easier to me, I think. But, I mean, so I'm trying to practice, yeah, more exaggerated movements, honestly. It's different kind of dancing style, so that's what I've been doing.
Now, and some people, they record themselves dancing, and then they review the footage later to do a recap. Do you do that, too?
Oh, actually, I do do that. Yes, I do. I want to see, like, what I need to work on, and I mean, you see, like, the kind of little things, you do point them out, so yeah, you do.
Yeah, so what are your current plans for conventions this year? I don't know if we just answered that or not.
Yeah, okay, so I got Cal Fur, and then Arizona Fur Con. I'm also thinking about Rocky Mountain Fur Con, and for sure MFF. So I'm still debating on RF, I don't know for sure, because based on my school schedule, so we'll have to play that one by ear. But yeah, I got about four more cons to go.
I mean, that's kind of like why you kind of like you jumped off from us too, is because you started getting like more work and just you had like a tougher schedule to work with school and, you know, your job. So
Oh my god,
that's what I was left to believe, and I think that's what it was the entire time.
It's my life's like school, honestly, like 24/7 right now for me. I mean, I want to get school done, obviously. I'm doing full time of it. I work aside too, doing my Starbucks job, and, you know, get a little bit of income, but it is so tough to keep everything.
I'm still surprised by the fact that you work in a Starbucks and yet you don't drink coffee. I mean, I know that's not necessarily uncommon, but I mean, the fact that you don't drink coffee at all, and it has nothing to do with the fact that you've worked in a Starbucks
I love coffee. I just don't need it. Like, I get, like, super jumpy and crazy, and I can't, stay still. Like, I actually drink tea, actually. It keeps me, like, it's a little good.
Tea gives you a lot of variety, too, because, I mean, coffee just has, like, that specific type of flavor. I mean, you can get very light with it or very bold, or you can get, like, chocolate or cinnamon, but there's it's a lot of, like, savory type of flavors. Mm-hmm. And with tea, you have a lot of very light, fruity, also savory, but it's a lot more, you know, flexibility. It's just more fun that way.
But, yeah, every once in a while, I'll treat myself. Like, beer, actually, it's pretty rare, to be honest, is coffee, but, like, yeah, it's just what it is. But I kind of get, like, I think the vibe, too, around people. When I work at my Starbucks, like, you get the energy, and people, you get the coffee, and, of course, they're all, like, hyper, whatever, and up, but, like, yeah, I don't need it.
So, back to the fursuit dancing that you've been doing, have you ever run into any, like, technical problems with your fursuit? Because, I mean, you keep your fursuit in pretty good condition, and it's, like, I'm not going to lie, like, you've had the fursuit for some time right now.
2 years almost.
And it still looks, you know, pretty white.
Oh god.
And I'm very surprised, because most people who have like a white fursuit, it goes from like white to like a very like ugly looking beige. And it's just kind of hard to look at, and you're like, I don't know if that's really like if it came beige or if it's just they never wash it.
I am pretty like OCD about my suit, I'll be honest. Like I constantly like, I mean, I don't clean it like every day. I mean, okay, I'll suit and then I'll obviously do my spray and I'll like brush it and this and that. I mean, I do like the, I keep the white as, you know, as white as I can get. But I mean, yeah, I like, I mean, it's an expensive suit. I mean, it's a lot of money and, you know, investing in something like that. And it's, of course, I think you would want to take care of it. I mean, if you care for it, but I want to look good and, you know, so.
So how do you manage school, work, and your involvement in the furry fandom? That I've wanted to know, because with the people that I work with, I get to, you know, see a lot of their life. I work with them a lot, but you are like one of the few members in the group that I just never really got to know on like that personal level. So how do you really balance all that stuff out?
Honestly, it's just writing down a schedule and a planner. I'm a huge planner. I like write everything down, like, hey, what do I need to get done and how am I going to spread this out? But I mean, like, I'll have a calendar or 2 months or 3 months ahead. And I'll just write things down, like, okay, this is what's going on. And it's just that, I think, really, just putting a planner, just getting a planner and putting things down, because I think it just organizes your thoughts and everything you got to do. But, like, that's what I do, honestly. That's my little secret, I guess. So, I don't know. I guess some people don't do that. I don't know. So.
And you're going to school. Are you comfortable telling, like, what you're going to school for?
Yeah. I'm actually studying to be a nurse. I'm trying to aim for my BSN, of course, because I have a love for people, and I love, like, taking care of others, and...
Now, is that like in college or are you going to a trade school? Because I think they both can give you nursing.
Yeah, I'm actually just at, right now, currently I'm at a community college and I'm going to be transferring to a university actually in a year.
Oh, okay.
Up. So I'll be getting into a program, a nursing program, which is a 2 years for that, for the AD, and then I'm going to be transferring to the BSN program, which is online actually, which is awesome.
I would imagine I imagine nursing is more of a hands-on type of career. So I mean, I wonder how that would work being online.
Yeah, I don't know. I know for the 2 years, once you get in the program, it is hands-on. And then after that, they have an option if you want to do online or not. But I'm kind of leaning more online because like based on my schedule, it's a little easier for me. So I don't know. It's just how it works. But
yeah, so I mean, but it's good though to know that you know you're trying to keep yourself, you know, busy, you're trying to cover all your bases, you know, can be a very difficult thing to do. And you know, most people, as much as they want to do it, it just doesn't always work. So props to you for having the energy to keep going through that. And but I've seen the side of you where, because I'm when I came back from Arizona FurCon, I did have to like stop by your place because the car broke down.
Yeah.
And I saw the most calm version of you ever. I wasn't sure if you were like just really mellow and tired, or if you were just like having like a spell that day, because I didn't see a smile come from you. You're like, okay, I gotta go to work. I got books. I'm ready. But you were just very focused. I'm like, holy shit. Who is she and what have you done to Kai?
I'm just, I don't know, my focus mode in school. I don't know. You gotta be a little bit, okay, you gotta get in the level to... Okay, it's school time, it's work time.
Yes,
work,
you know how to balance. You know how to balance it out pretty well.
Energy,
that's good.
And stress.
How'd you learn to develop that kind of balance?
Honestly, it's just experiences. I guess you could say like things that you go through, and you just learn over time. I think. I don't know.
Oh, well, I mean, I'm glad to be able to like recap with you because this was the chance I had to like actually just talk to her and you know get to like see how she's doing, because I don't get to speak to her as much. And I see you on Twitter.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, since we don't really advertise the former members on the website anymore, that usually just keeps it with the immediate members. But you can find her on Twitter at thatcrazycanine, and crazy is with a K.
Yes.
And I believe that's also on FA as well, right?
Yes. Okay, Twitter. Yeah. And yeah, that should be good.
All right, so yeah, you guys can find her there if you want to keep in touch with her and see what else she's up to. And with that, we will be cutting it here. So remember, it's bi-weekly on Wednesdays. Be sure to subscribe for more. And you know how it is.
Woo!